So Tanya's asked me to ask her some questions and see what, meanwhile you can see her work on the screens above us. So Tanya, tell us about yourself first of all.
Okay, well, I'm an artist, I've created a career and a living out of being a painter of people and a painter of myself and a painter of how society.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but everybody here thinks we need the sound down. If you don't,
Tammy.
Yeah, we can take the sound down, sorry.
How do you identify yourself in doing all of this?
Well, I identify myself as a disabled artist, but also as an artist. I see the two living side by side. Sometimes I'm just an artist, sometimes I'm a disabled artist. It depends on the fight that I'm doing or the piece that I'm working on.
And. Why do you make portraits of disabled cultural figures?
Well, I kind of think that I started creating portraits of disabled cultural figures because I didn't see these portraits in our galleries when I went to visit galleries. And I wanted to record all the people that had done who have fought their fight to get us where we are today, and I wanted those people to be respected and to not be forgotten.
And how does that relate to the Ndaka collection? I think some of your works are going to be in that.
Some of it, I think nearly all of it. I've got mountains and mountains of portraits. In fact, I'm just sitting here. There are a few faces in here that I've done, including David, which we'll see in a minute. We've done Tony, we've just seen in his slideshow. We've got Baroness Jane, wherever she is.
She's over there.
Yeah. And I'm seeing lots of faces in here that I think, oh, let's put a few more in there. So it's kind of become this kind of lifetime's work, where I'm kind of, I feel like I'm here, but on this planet, to do the portraits of disabled people, especially the disabled people who got there and done that.
And people will see all of those at the archive, which is opening next March, is it?
Next year, yeah, 2018.
2018 at High Wycombe.
Clubs, website, films, other sites.
And you've got a brochure all about it in your book.
All the different portraits. I also kind of like to encourage the audience to be participatory part of the portrait making process as well. Because I'm seeing all your faces and I'm thinking, so I've got all of those in the portraits as well. Because you're just as important. You're just as important as the person who's doing the fighting, because you're doing the fighting as well.
And I see you're trying to be as inclusive as possible. We've got, seen as we've been going through here, groups of people with learning difficulties, other groups. So how do you go about working with that group of people?
Well, working with learning disabled people is kind of like a passion of mine. I'm very interested in other people's visual language, how they make work, what their ambitions things are, I want to support those artists to develop their work in a professional manner as well. And it's a very collaborative process as well. So it's not just about kind of taking somebody to a gallery to say, oh yeah, put pictures of them. It's very practical.
And the last question, because we are in time on time, I see that on some of these you've been let loose in museums to see the portrayal of the past. How's that figured into your work?
Well, that's tracing the history of disability that's represented. There's like David Heaving, and then we're kind of looking at the other portraits that I've done. And I'd like to see the historical portraits of disability married with a more contemporary vision as well.
Thanks very much. That's great. Thank you.